Welcome, everyone. And our guest today is my favorite Russian friend, Irina Alexander. Please welcome Irina. And Irina, thank you so much for dedicating a little bit of time today to help share your story to help others in their entrepreneurial dreams and aspirations to kind of kick in and understand where to focus to be successful as you have built multiple businesses and things like that. So if you wouldn't mind real quick, for everyone who's watching, tell me a little bit about you, a little bit about your journey and the businesses that you've created.
All right. Well, hello, everybody. Like Dr. Hartley said, I'm also known as your favorite Russian, but my name is Irina Alexander, and I'm a serial entrepreneur. I'm in my early 30s, and so far I have built and sold 3 businesses. I started fairly early. My first business, I believe I was 21, and it was a retail store in Russia. And my latest business is heating air conditioning. Started with myself and my husband in 2016 when he lost a job, when we decided there's no better opportunity and choice than to do our own business we've been dreaming about. Long story short, he went back to work and I started to run business full time by myself with 3 kids. Whoa, 2 kids under the age of 3. And it was successful. In 2 years, we reached almost $1 million in revenue and became well known in a small business industry around the Austin area.
When you were in the process of really kind of building this business out, the most recent one that you recently sold a handful of months ago, what were some of those lessons that you learned in previous businesses or even just along the journey that helped you create your most successful business yet, which was the most recent one that you sold, the HVAC one? What were some of those lessons that maybe you wish you had applied to the earlier businesses that you did to this one that helped make it so successful?
Well, one thing I know for sure, it doesn't matter what country you run your business, problems are always the same. Business is a mess, and it's really, there's no excuse to say you're in a different country and those rules don't apply to you. That is not true. I know that myself. There were plenty and plenty of lessons learned that I wish I would know. And I think employees, how to hire people and hire them for their attitude and mindset versus their knowledge of how they do things. You can train them in a labor field, but you cannot change their mindset. So you need to hire for their attitude. That's a lesson definitely learned hard way and will be applied. Will be applied in the future in any of my other businesses I will be starting hopefully soon. So that's kind of a big one. Also, just know your numbers. I learned that from my first business and applied it very well in this business. Just spreadsheets, numbers down, you know, from big goals to small goals, from big numbers of the yearly revenue down to monthly revenue, down to weekly revenue. So all those numbers are very important to know. And hire the right people around you. You can't do everything yourself, so you need to surround yourself with a team of people that help you to run your business smoothly.
So a bit of an interesting question. It's been said that smart people learn from their mistakes and wise people learn from the mistakes of others. So along the journey that you've had, what mistakes did you make along the way and how can other entrepreneurs kind of learn from your experience?
Mistakes that can others learn from me. Once again, I can go back to hiring. Crazy stories that one of my, well, the first employee I hired, he stole from me large as of, you know, a vehicle and equipment, and he is now sitting in prison. So that's, I do not wish anybody go through that experience because I realize how small businesses are unprotected in a lot of ways. I also learned how importance of the setting up the right contract with your employees, make sure that they sign everything. You need to document everything. You need to have everything scanned and put into files. And a lot of times it's even easier to do it, hire a third party company to do your payroll and put that liability on somebody else. I think that is very important. I mean, the only reason I was able to actually get it moving from employer perspective as of open a case against my employee who stole from me is because I had all the documents that what kind of equipment he received, what kind of vehicle he received, down to VIN number and everything. Everything was in writing. Everything was signed by him. But it took about 5 police officers to come to our place of work to finally write official statements, say, yes, we agreed to open the case. It was crazy. So for me is don't do anything behind the table. Do everything legal and have a paper trail of everything, even digital now. You can scan it, you can eliminate all the papers, but make sure that it's on paper first, properly signed, and then put it on file, scan it.
You know, protecting the individuals of the business and the business itself is very important. And as a new business owner, especially if they're looking to hire a team for the very first time, if they're in kind of that mode, it can be a very daunting task. And, you know, having a system for around, you know, to have around it and things to put in place for a reason is really important. So I appreciate you sharing that. When you decided to open up the HVAC business, my guess, you've probably never done HVAC in your life. Would I be right, wrong on that one?
Correct. I only knew that there is an AC and there is a thermostat. You just push the buttons and you turn on the AC or heat. That was my knowledge of the industry.
Which I would personally attribute to one of the reasons why it became so successful for you, because something that, you know, we see a lot is if the business owner knows how to do the job of the business, they end up just building themselves a job. Versus for you, you didn't know it. So you had to go find other individuals to run the business for you. And then you were able to be the true CEO and owner of it. Any thoughts as you kind of walked down that path of walking, you know, opening up a business that, you know, you knew nothing about?
I think it's very important to work on a business and not in a business. And you hear that a lot. And a lot of people say, what does it mean exactly? So don't get your own hands dirty. Hire people that know what they're doing. You just need to make sure they believe in you. Share your vision, mission. Explain to them why you're hiring them and what you need from them. Because for me, as a woman in a very man-dominated industry, which about 90%, if not more, of my employees were male, I had to show them the strengths and the vision that first I can run this business. And the other thing is that this is what we're going to build all together. So sharing that with them is very important. And then once again, just everybody have their own job assignment. That's what they do and show them, okay, each of you playing a major role, but all together we are building an empire and that's what we're going to do. So for me, that's what I tried to do when I was hiring people is to just, yes, I might not know how to fix your HVAC, but I have a professional team. They know how to do that. And I'm just making sure that the whole processes are run correctly and they know what they're doing. But I'm not getting my hands dirty. And like I usually say, that the only time I probably will wear HVAC uniform is it's a Halloween time when we go trick-or-treat with kids. Because everybody's like, hey, can you come and fix it? I was like, sure, it's going to cost you maybe too much. So, yeah, but definitely work on your business and not in your business. That's way you can see a bigger picture and not just focus on day-to-day work and operations.
That's awesome. As we wrap up today, is there anything additional that you'd like to mention or say or plug for yourself or anything like that as the audience starts to watch this and as we wrap up today?
I want to touch on the fear. A lot of people are afraid to start their business. They're afraid of failure. They're afraid what other people going to think about them, especially if they're coming from corporate America and they had a six or even seven figure job and they are starting something completely new and different to them. And there is a lot of fear and unknowns. And I want to say, just do it. I mean, for me, I can't say I wasn't afraid, which my husband thinks so. He thinks that I am never afraid. I just jump in and figure out how things are done. But overall is the fear of regret, I think, terrifies me more. I'm really afraid to regret at the end of my life that I haven't done something or I haven't tried something. That's why I just do it, and there is no right or wrong. No, there is no the answer until you really try it, and don't do your best. Do what it takes, and you will see results for sure.
That is awesome. Thank you again for investing a little bit of your time today with us. If anyone wants to reach out to Irina, we'll have any of the pertinent contact information in the comments below. So thank you again for today, for sharing your wisdom and expertise and past and history and learnings with us. I really appreciate it. I'm Dr. Michael Hartley. This is Irina Alexander. We're here to elevate your business and enhance your lifestyle and make it a great day.